All set?
Yes, sir. Tailpipe clear.
Tailpipe clear. Oh, all this stuff on.
Coming up. close, you'll see those little black dots under the bottom of the airplane. That's the landing gear. And brake, how do you read me now? We're having radio problems, I guess. Okay, well, we've got the airplane set up. And now you see him, and now you don't. Now you see him, now you don't. One more time on the cheap seats. Now you see him, now you don't. And Frank, for some reason, I'm not reading you, so we're just going to go ahead and do a little bit of a monologue here until you get that straightened out. Go ahead and put the airplane up in the air here, do a little turnaround, and come back in with a maneuver we call the knife edge pass. We lay the airplane up on its side, and see how long we can fly it there. Won't be too awful long, but we've got a real good camera out there, good focus on the old lens. You might be able to see the silver bullet cruise light on top of the wings there. Show line on the outside edge of the runway. And we're on speed. Try to get a little smoke on here. And nose up, and over we go. Hold it there for a little bit. Some of that stuff. Okay, go put full power to it, and up we go.
Well, when you start to sort of sink down there, it makes me nervous, Bobby.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's acting to be a pretty comfy today. This airplane is really putting out the power here at this kind of altitude. Yeah, whatever you said there, Frank, we're gonna break it up a little bit on us here. Yeah, we're 220 knots on speed. We're flying right on down to the far end of the field here. Go ahead and turn some smoke on. And up we go, a little power coming up. About 4.5 positive G's. Up and over the top. Okay, I'm still picking you up a little on the carpal side here, but I'll tell you what, I'm hoping I can hear the count, so when I start there, you just go right to it, eh? not in part of the area. So we're going to turn right back around now and set up our finale maneuver, the vertical 4-point roll and tail slide. So I get 4 points out of this thing going right straight up before this thing comes to a stop, and so it looks like the world's largest lawn dart. As a matter of fact, that's what usually happens.
Couple little problems, but nothing that we don't know what's going on.
You know what's going on?
Yes.
To begin with, the whole sound system guy was overeating when we were going down the taxi.
Yeah, that sounded like our problem.
But anyway, and then Frank unplugged the headset. I was standing there just watching.
So,
yeah, but we have a problem with our system. I could not read it because I'm getting a chop and it comes in choppy. We have a short in the system. It's a bit open. It's in the cable. It's like a little bit and it stops. A little bit and it stops. So it's our system.
You got good sight tone and everything.
I've got great. Everything's great. Were you reading me? Okay?
Yeah, it was sounding
great. Yeah. So I'm just saying,
so I think you got the radio. As far as
the Sukhoi Su-26M, this is an airplane that was initially designed in 1984 in the Soviet Union, specifically funded by the government, specifically.
Eric, stay on the headset till I... Oh, well.
Just hang on there, Eric, until I tell you. We'll get the music started. We'll do the radio check-in with you. Eric, I'm ready to go if he's ready.
There, guys. Land this thing.
Okay, we can be taxiing out while he's landing.
He's ready to start music.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, let's start.
Silver Bullet. We're just going to assume that you're reading me. I'm not reading you at all. So we're going to go ahead and complete the cockpit checklist here. We've got battery switch is on. Fuel symmetrical belts are tight. Controls are free. Trim set. Attenuator is in the open position. All instruments look like they're in the green. Got the canopy locked. So I'm going to flip on the power here. Be rolling on the Silver Bullet shortly. And we're on roll. Looking for about 60 knots on the liftoff out here. Accelerates right on out. Be pulling the landing gear up now. And just kind of going easy up on the flaps. And brake. Got to hit the Silver Bullet now.
Okay.
Now we're having the same kind of radio problem we're having yesterday for some reason. We thought we had it fixed, but no. I'll tell you what, Frank, you may have noticed how fast that landing gear went up. Well, I'm going to turn right back around and show folks how fast this landing gear really does work.
That's
right, Ray. We'll be putting the landing gear down here. It'd be little tiny wheels now, about the size of lawnmower tires. Gear coming out, and I've got it out now. And we're right down the show line, the full flight idle now, trying to slow this little puppy down. Hey, we're down to about 120 knots, it's still decelerating. Okay now folks, you have to look real quick now because this is a fast landing gear. Because now you see him and now you don't. Now you see him, now you don't. And with the cheap seats over here, now you see him, now you don't. And Frank, I'm going to go ahead and put full power to it here. Going to kick the nose in the air just a little bit. And we're going to come back around whatever we call the knife edge pass. Be laying the airplane up on its side. Photographers out there with a real sharp focus on the old camera might be able to pick up that quarter light on top of the wings.
All right, when you come around this time, in other words, the wings will be right angles to the ground. Makes a great picture. He comes back to the left side.
That's right, Frank. We're going to do the old picture shot here. Up through 150 knots right now. Coming back out of full power. Looks like we'd be on plenty of speed here today. 180 knots, we're on speed. I'm going to go ahead and turn the smoke on so people can see this little thing.
Five, six, seven, nine, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12,
Barry Rice Orchestra and Love Thief. What do you think?
I think that's a great idea, and we'll just watch.
Okay, sounds good to me. All right, down the backside we come. We're going to do a bit of a recall of the roller coaster to start this sequence off. It'll be about a 5 positive G pull up to a half roll going vertical, about 3 negative.